We will now listen to a great American and a dedicated leader, the acknowledged champion of civil rights in America, Mr. Roy Wilkins, Executive Secretary, National Association for the Advancement of Colored People. Brother Roy Wilkins.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Put on, Roy. Put on, Roy.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Randolph. First of all, I want to thank all of you for coming here today because you saved me from being a liar. I told them you would be here. They didn't believe me because you always make up your mind at the last minute. And you had me scared. But isn't it a great day?
Yes.
My friends, we're here today because we want the Congress of the United States to hear from us in person what many of us have been telling our public officials back home, and that is, we want freedom now. We came here to petition our lawmakers to be as brave as our sit-ins and our marchers, to be as daring as James Meredith, to be as unafraid as the nine children of Little Rock, and to be as forthright as the governor of North Carolina, and to be as dedicated as the Archbishop of St. Louis. We came to speak here to our Congress, to those men and women who speak here for us in that marble forum over yonder on the Hill. They know from their vantage point here of the greatness of this whole nation, of its reservoirs of strength, and of the sicknesses which threaten always to sap its strength and to erode in one or another selfish and stealthy and specious fashion the precious liberty of the individual, which is the hallmark of our country among the nations of the earth. We have come asking the enactment of legislation that will affirm the right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, and that will place the resources and the honor of the government of all the people behind the Pledge of Equality and the Declaration of Independence. We want employment, and with it, we want the pride and responsibility and self-respect that goes with equal access to jobs. Therefore, we want an FEPC bill as a part of the legislative package. Now, my friends all over this land, and especially in parts of the Deep South, we are beaten and kicked and maltreated and shot and killed by local and state law enforcement officers. It is simply incomprehensible to us here today and to millions of others far from this spot that the United States government, which can regulate the contents of a pill, apparently is powerless to prevent the physical abuse of citizens within its own borders. The Attorney General must be empowered to act on his own initiative in the denial of any civil right, not just one or two, but any civil right, in order to wipe out this shameful situation. Now, the President's proposals represent so moderate an approach that if it is weakened or eliminated, the remainder will be little more than sugar water. Indeed, as it stands today, the package needs strengthening, and the President should join us in fighting to be sure that we get something more than PAP. And finally, we hear talk of protocol and procedures and rules, including the Senate filibuster rule. Well, we have a thought on that. We declare that rules are made to enable the Congress to legislate and not to keep it from legislating. And we're tired of hearing rules cited as a reason why they can't act. Now, we expect the passage of an effective civil rights bill. We commend those Republicans in both houses who are working for it. We salute those Democrats in both houses who are working for it. In fact, we even salute those from the South who want to vote for it but don't dare to do so. And we say to those people, just give us a little time, and one of these days, we'll emancipate you. It'll get to the place where they can come to a civil rights rally, too. If those who support the bill will fight for it as hard and as skillfully as the Southern opposition fights against it, victory will be ours. When we return home, keep up the speaking by letter and telegram and telephone, and wherever possible, by a personal visit. Remember that this has been a long fight. We were reminded of it by the news of the death yesterday in Africa of Dr. W.E.B. Du Bois. Now, regardless of the fact that in his later years, Dr. Du Bois chose another path, it is incontrovertible that at the dawn of the 20th century, his was the voice that was calling to you to gather here today in this cause. If you want to read something that applies to 1963, go back and get a volume of The Souls of Black Folks by Du Bois, published in 1903. Well, my friends, you got religion here today. Don't blackslide tomorrow. Remember Luke's account of the warning that was given to us all. No man, he wrote, having put his hand to the plow and looking back, is fit for the kingdom of God. Thank you.